Good evening, God bless you. Hello, hello, good evening, God bless you. Good evening, good evening. You are all welcome to God's presence. Hello, everyone, good evening. God bless you. Happy New Month to you all. Hallelujah. God bless you. God bless you all. You are all welcome. It's another day again. Amen. Praise the Lord. Happy New Month to you all. You are all welcome once again. You are all welcome. You are all welcome. I hope you all have a lovely day today. Good evening. Good afternoon. Depends on the time you are watching me from. Happy New Week to everyone. Happy New Week. You are all welcome to God's presence. Hallelujah. Amen. It's another day again. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise the Lord, somebody. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You are all welcome. Thank you all for coming online. Thank you all for coming online. Appreciate you all for watching. I appreciate you all for coming online again. You are welcome, brother. You are welcome, sister. You are all welcome. Thank you all for coming online. May God bless and reward every one of us in Jesus' name. Happy New Month to you all. Hallelujah. You are welcome, brother Uyi Efe. God bless you. Thanks for coming online, brother Monday Isibo. God bless you. Thanks for coming online. God bless you. God bless you. Rosie Agdagbon. God bless you. Thanks for coming online. Thanks for coming online. You are all welcome. I appreciate you all. Blessing Owe, thank you for coming online. God bless you. God bless you, Larry Akin. God bless you. Thank you all for coming online. I appreciate you all. May God bless and reward you all in Jesus' name. Happy New Month to you all in Jesus' name. Amen. Hallelujah. Before we start the message of today, let's celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ with a lovely song. Let's appreciate him in our life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Listen and be blessed in Jesus' name. Dance to the glory of God. We are in new month. Amen. We have all the right to be happy, to celebrate our Lord Jesus Christ. You are all welcome. Thank you. Listen and be blessed in Jesus' name. Thank you all. Thank you all for watching. We are coming online every Thursday, 7 p.m. and Sunday, 7 p.m. to encourage ourselves with the word of God. Hallelujah. May God bless you all as you come, as you watch and share this video and like and comment. May God Almighty reward you all in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. I also have my YouTube channel now, which is Veronica TV. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Veronica TV, V capital letter, then E-R-O-N-I-C-A. Then TV is T capital letter and V small letter. Veronica TV. That is my YouTube channel. Thank you all for watching. Also follow me on my YouTube channel. All my videos are there. Even the one I'm doing now is going to still upload there as I finish this Facebook you can go straight to my YouTube channel. Praise the Lord. Please like and share, and also subscribe to my YouTube channel. And God Almighty will bless you all. We are doing this program all together. Amen. Baba, you are welcome, Baba Christian. Christian, God bless you. Tessie Omolo, Omelo, God bless you. You are welcome. You are all welcome. I appreciate you all for coming online. Happy New Month to everyone. God bless you all for coming. Like and share this video. Hallelujah. God bless you, brother and sister. You are welcome. Rafa Atiti, God bless you. God bless you, Christian Osayawe. You are welcome. Good evening, brother. God bless you, sister. Sister Love, God bless you. You are welcome. God bless you, sister. Thank you. The Lord Almighty have done a great thing in our life for seeing new month. Thanks to the glory of God. He have done a great thing in your life. Oh, no, no. Oh, no, no, no. Oh, no, no. Thank you, sister. God bless you. Happy New Month to everyone in Jesus' name. Amen. To your son, Sire. Sire. Hallelujah. Oh, yeah, Hallelujah. God bless you all. Thank you for coming online. I appreciate you all. You are welcome. Swiss Golden. God bless you. Thank you all for watching. Thank you, Sister Lovett. God bless you. I appreciate you all for coming online. May God bless everyone in Jesus' name. Amen. May His name be praised in our life for making us to see this new month in good health and happiness. Thank you, King of Glory. This hour, before we go to the message of today, let's appreciate God in our life. Let's give God the glory, the praise, adoration to His holy name. For all He has done in our life, for making us to see this new month in good health, let's give God adoration in the name of Jesus. Father, we appreciate you. We reverence your holy name, O Lord God. We say, take all the glory, all the honor, adoration for all you have done in our life, O Lord King of Glory. For making us to see this new month in good health, O Lord Father, we appreciate you. We say, may your name be praised forever. Not because we are holy nor righteous, but because of your mercy you have kept us to this time, O Lord. Lord King of Glory, you that have started good thing in our life, that have started keeping us from January to this time, Lord Father, may your protection continue to be upon us in our going out and coming in the mighty name of Jesus. King of Glory, Lord God, premature death will not be of our portion. Father, every good of this month will not pass us by in the mighty name of Jesus. Your favor this month will not pass us by. Father, we shall move forward and backward never in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord God, you remember all this, oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Take all the glory, all the honor, adoration. As we have come together again, O Lord, to study your word, Lord Father, we pray that Holy Spirit come and teach us your word. Let us not speak on our own way, O Lord, King of Glory. May your Holy Spirit direct us, O Lord God. I humble myself before you, O Lord God, for your Holy Spirit to use. Father, Lord, may you come and take control. That at the end of each year of, O Lord, I will have cause to say thank you. We all will have cause to say thank you. In the mighty name of Jesus, I cover everyone online now with the blood of Jesus. As many see coming on the way, we are covered with the blood of Jesus. Lord God, let us not just gather in vain, Lord God. Let us benefit from your word. That at the end, O Lord King of glory, your name will be praised forever. And our life will not remain the same. Take all the glory, all the honor, adoration for all you have done in each and every one of our lives. For in Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. God bless you all. God bless you, sister. Unstoppable, you are welcome. Thank you for coming online. You are welcome. Sister Osenaga, God bless you. God bless you, sister. You are welcome. I'm very sorry for what happened. God bless you for coming online. I tried to get to you, but maybe we're not online. God bless you for coming online. Thank you all for coming. Appreciate you all in Jesus' name. Without wasting time, let's go straight to the message of today. Our topic of today is honor your father and your mother and appreciate them so that your days may be long. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. God bless you. Hallelujah. We are welcome, Sister Pat. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Honor your father and your mother so that your days may be long. Appreciate them. Hallelujah. God bless you all. Amen. Which is taken from the book of Deuteronomy 5:16. Hallelujah. From the book of Deuteronomy 5:16. If you have your Bible there, you can open to the book of Deuteronomy 5:16. Which says, honor your father and your mother so as the Lord your God has commanded you, so that your days may be long and it may be well with you in the land that God giveth thee. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. It is our duty. Hallelujah. Let us not look at them because they are poor. Maybe we come from a poor home. Hallelujah. It is your responsibility as a child of God to honor your father and your mother. Appreciate them, those that still have parents alive. Appreciate them when they are alive. Honor them when they are alive, not when they are gone. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. That is all we are going to be studying today. As I said before, this program is every Thursday, 7 p.m. and Sunday, 7 p.m. I'm coming online to encourage ourselves with the word of God so that our life will not remain the same. Hallelujah. Let's be doing one or two things concerning our life. Let's be changing things concerning our life so that our life will not remain the same. It's a practical lesson of what I'm talking about. Hallelujah. Let's examine ourselves. In any area we are not living right, that we are lacking in all this area, we should try and amend our way. God bless you, sister. Unstoppable. Thank you for sharing. Hallelujah. Let us try and amend our way because nobody knows tomorrow. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. When you have the spirit of forgiveness, you can be able to honor them and appreciate them. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Let us not look at the background where they come from because they were not able to train you up. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Number two says, honor your father and your mother even if they are poor. Even if they are poor or if they are rich. It doesn't matter. Some come from a poor parent, some come from a rich parent. Praise the Lord. Your parents are still your parents. Your mother is your mother. Your father is your father. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. You can't change that. It is God that have created you to come through them. Praise the Lord. So honor them and respect them. Hallelujah. Appreciate them. Hallelujah. Because they brought you to this world. Amen. When they are alive, that is when it is important. It is very important now when they are alive, not when they are gone. Hallelujah. Let us not do the one when they are already gone. We celebrate. We celebrate when they are gone. We try to do it in a big form so that people will praise us and be saying and be talking about it, the way they do the burial and all everything. That is for just, it's just celebrating. It's like celebrating for people. The person that is gone is already gone. Praise the Lord. We don't know anything that you are doing for him anymore. The one he will value is when he's still alive. Hallelujah. Let's try and forgive them and appreciate them and honor them when they are alive. Hallelujah. God bless you. Thanks for coming, ITZ. God bless you. Hallelujah. When they are still alive, it's very important for us. Amen. That is the joy of parents. To see their children grown up and also respect them and appreciate them and take care of them. Hallelujah. Don't look at whatever they might have done in the past. Praise the Lord. Don't rely on the past. Hallelujah. Yes, sister, the Bible verse is taken from the book of Deuteronomy 5:16. Hallelujah. God bless you, brother Abodefe. You are welcome. God bless you. God bless you, sister Otako. You are welcome. Hallelujah. It's taken from the book of Deuteronomy 5:16, the verse. Hallelujah. Let's follow me up with your Bible there. Also, you see the verse so that we read all together. We are studying the word of God together. We are correcting ourselves with the word of God together. Nobody is exempted, including myself. I'm encouraging everyone with the word of God so we all can amend our way and not remain the same. Let us not remain the same. Let's start doing something about our life. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Because nobody knows tomorrow. Nobody knows tomorrow. Amen. Some people disrespect their parents because they were not able to help them, train them. Hallelujah. Maybe they did not have time for them. Hallelujah. Some abandoned them because they were so harsh to them, too hard. Hallelujah. They were scared of their father or their parents. They maltreated them. Hallelujah. Some grow up in a different way. Everybody didn't grow up in the same way. We all grow up different way because we all came from different parents. Some receive different treatment from their parents. Hallelujah. And because of the result of that, some decide to not honor them anymore. Some people may insult their parents. Some may not respect them. Some may not appreciate them. Hallelujah. That is because we have the spirit of unforgiveness. Hallelujah. When you have the spirit of forgiveness, you can be able to honor them, respect them, appreciate them, and take care of them. Hallelujah. Let charity start from our house, from our home. Hallelujah. If we cannot love our parents, if we cannot forgive our parents, there is nothing that will make us to love other people or forgive other people. It will start from our home, our own close one. Hallelujah. Amen. It is our duty. The word of God says so. That's the word of God. Say, honor your father and your mother so that your days may be long, so that it shall be well with you in the land of the living. God bless you, Sister Victoria. You are welcome. Hallelujah. If we call ourselves a child of God, let us obey the word of God. Hallelujah. Number one is to forgive. Amen. When you forgive, you will never abandon them. Hallelujah. You will not disrespect them because that is not the word of God. That is not the will of God concerning your life to disrespect your senior to talk less of your own parents. Hallelujah. Amen. Let us continue. Obey them. In the book of Ephesians 6:1-4, says, children, obey your parents in the Lord, for this is right. Hallelujah. For this is right. Amen. We are talking about parents today. Many don't have parents today. But they will say, I wish I have parents. I bet some have parents today. But what do they do? Hallelujah. Have the spirit of forgiveness and able to care for them and respect them, appreciate them. Hallelujah. It's when they are alive they will value it, not when they are gone. Even if you do anything, you close the whole street when they are gone, you never appreciate it anymore. You are just doing it for people, for the lives, people that are watching, people that will come. You did it for people. God bless you, sister. Thank you for watching. You did it for people. Hallelujah. Amen. Same to you, sister. Happy new month. Say to you and your family. God bless you, sister. So it's what you do for them now. Hallelujah. It's what you do for them now. Some of us, we have the opportunity to do, to help them, to do anything for them, but because of unforgiveness, we refuse to help, we refuse to care for them, we refuse to honor them, we refuse to respect them, we refuse to appreciate them because of the spirit of unforgiveness. Hallelujah. If they die tomorrow, can you see them anymore? You will never see them anymore. You cannot do anything for them anymore. What will be our gain? When we have the chance to let them enjoy us and we fail to do so, we will not gain anything. Hallelujah. It's nobody else than your parents. You are not doing it for anybody. You are doing it for your parents. Wherever you are watching me from, whether you are in Nigeria, whether you are in Europe, in anywhere you are watching me from, if you have the privilege to see her parents, appreciate them, value them, and honor them. Hallelujah. Because it's the word of God concerning your life. If you know you are a child of God. Hallelujah. Amen. So we stand outside, insulting their parents. Stand outside. Before the mother will say any word, you just repeat 3 or 4 words. Repeat with insult. Some fight with their parents. Some do different kind of things. Hallelujah. That is not the will of God concerning our life. We are disobeying the word of God when we do so. Amen. Praise the Lord. To honor our father and mother does not end when you have grown up and move out. Some end it in that way. When they are under their parents, they honor them, they respect them, they appreciate them, they humble. But when they move out, it's end. Finish. So because you no longer stay under his roof or her roof, so there's no respect anymore, no more appreciating them. You are just going on your own. You abandon them. They are just like that. No. Hallelujah. Let it not be so. Amen. Let it not be so. God bless you, sister. Some did not do it purposely, but because of what the parents did to them, they decide to change their mind. But when we do so, we are not obeying the word of God. Because the Bible says, forgive so that your sins shall be forgiven. Forgive. It's not anybody else they are telling you to forgive. They are telling you to forgive your parents who brought you to this world. Hallelujah. Some may offend their children. Not all parents are perfect. Some may offend them in one way or the other, that they will just turn their back against them. But no. Even though they do such thing that offended you, that pains you so much, they are still your parents. You can never change that name and say they are no longer your parents and call someone else to be your parents. It can never be. Hallelujah. Amen. Even if people bribe to pay for other people's parents to present themselves as parents. Maybe sometimes people are doing marriage. Many things happen these days. When they are doing marriage, they can rent parents to do parents for them. They can do anything for other people to just present as their parent. But you are deceiving yourself. Nothing can change it. Your parents, they are still your parents. They are your blood. Hallelujah. God bless you, Pastor Christy. You are welcome. They are still your parents. Nothing can change that. So let us know that. Hallelujah. Yes, sister. No matter what happened, they are the one that brought us up. Hallelujah. God bless you, Sister Victoria. That's what happens. Some just decide to turn their back against them because of one thing or the other. But if we rely on that and stand on it, saying that we are bad, they will not care for them anymore. No, we are not living the Christ-like. We are not applying the word of God in our life because the word says, forgive so that your sins shall be forgiven. He said, love yourself as your neighbor. Love your neighbor as yourself. Hallelujah. Love your neighbor as yourself. How can you love your neighbor when you did not love your parents? See, that is impossible. That is pretense. When you say you love your neighbor as yourself, when you have not loved your parents, you cannot forgive your parents. Who else can you forgive? Forgive them. Because only one thing, only that you say you hold in mind, it can lead anyone to hellfire. Hallelujah. Because if you forgive, you will not abandon them. You will not say, because they didn't take care of you when you were young, he was too harsh to you, that he locked you outside, he was beating you up, he was doing so many things to you. Some don't treat their own children like their own children. They treat them like their slave. Hallelujah. Thank you, Pastor. God bless you. Some treat them like their slave. Some parents treat them like their children, their slaves. Some parents are like that. They are like that. But because they don't know God, that's why they behave like that. But you that are in Christ now, you have to make a change. Hallelujah. Don't pay evil with evil. Forgive them. If it is little you have, anywhere you are, whether in Nigeria, anywhere, if it's little, give them the little, just like show concern. Hallelujah. Visit them. Hallelujah. Amen. That is when you have the spirit of forgiveness. That is when you can be able to do that. Amen. We need to be thankful for them. Let us show them that we are grateful. Amen. You can't show them that you are grateful when you don't have the spirit of forgiveness. You don't count anything that they do. You say, well, what did they do? They didn't do anything for me. I struggled myself before I arrived this position. They didn't do anything. What did they do? They didn't do nothing. I did everything by myself. That's what we will say. But let us not say so. Hallelujah. The next one says, communicate with them. God wants us to have deep relationship with others. But that deep relationship cannot start with. We cannot have deep relationship with others when we cannot have good relationship with our parents who brought you to this world. You don't have good relationship with them. How can you have good relationship with others? Is it possible? Charity begins at home. You must go and reconcile with your parents. You have a good relationship with them. Hallelujah. Before you can be able to have good relationship with others. Amen. Forgive yourself and forgive them. Don't rely on the bad memory. What they did to you in the past. No. You are not helping yourself. Hallelujah. Amen. In the book of Hebrews 13:1. Hallelujah. Hebrews 13:1 says, keep on loving one another as brothers and sisters. Keep on loving one another as brothers and sisters. How can you love one another when you don't have love for your parents? Hallelujah. Because you have love for them. If we have love for them, we will care for them. We will not disrespect them. We will appreciate them. Hallelujah. We will ask of them. We will call them. Hallelujah. We will not abandon them. We will visit them. Hallelujah. That's in the book of Hebrews 13:1. Hallelujah. Keep loving one another. Before we do so, we have to forgive our parents and love them before we can be able to love one another. Amen. Hallelujah. Not when they are gone. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Not when they are gone. There are so many people who celebrate their parents, do birthday for them, just doing get together for them. They want to see them, they record them. They want their. Happy with their parents, talking to them, everything. Hallelujah. That is what they gain from you when they are alive, not when they are gone. Do that for them. They will be very happy and bless you. Hallelujah. Don't pay evil with evil. Amen. Yes, sister, they gave us life. Thank you very much. Let us not pay evil with evil. Amen. Hallelujah. Ask about them, how they're feeling, how they're doing. Call them. Some don't call them. Some don't call their parents. Even if they're even in Nigeria. From this street, maybe one is living in Bobahi, the other one is in Ego. To even visit, they don't even visit. Just to visit, they can't even see. They are still in the same Nigeria, the Benin city. They can't visit. Hallelujah. They can't visit. Some will just only call. But it's not difficult to transport yourself to where they live. They can't visit. They just leave them like that. Hallelujah. God bless you, Sister Meze. You are welcome. Whether you are a male child or a female child, do your own part. Don't leave it for the female children. Hallelujah. They both gave birth to you. Whether you are a male child or female child, don't leave it for those your sisters. Say they are the women, they can take care of their parents. No, you do your own part. Doesn't mean you are a man. Hallelujah. Does not mean you are a man. Do your own part. That shows that you love them. That shows you appreciate them. Hallelujah. Amen. Some men take care of their parents more than some women. Hallelujah. It is not that it's very common, but some men that can take care of their parents more than even women, they don't play with it. They don't play at all. They always care for them. They are there for them. They don't disrespect. Don't allow anybody to disrespect them. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Provide for them. When you know they need your assistance, provide for them. Hallelujah. This is what you can do for them when they are alive. Hallelujah. This is what you can do when they are alive, not when they are gone. Amen. Some need your assistance. Some may not need because of the way they have their own money, they are rich. Some, they still need your assistance. Even if they are, you still do your own part. Hallelujah. Amen. Do your own part. Be concerned. Hallelujah. Some abandon their parents. It's only when they are sick, they will start running up and down. Then they will not care when they are sick or when they die. And I say, oh, it's time for burial now. Okay. Burial time. They are planning how to do burial. The person is gone. You don't know anything again. People that still have this advantage. Hallelujah. Use it wise. Forgive them. And honor them. Appreciate them. Hallelujah. So that the blessing that follow you will not pass you by. We abide with you. Hallelujah. Amen. In the book of 1 Timothy 5:8 says, anyone who does not provide for his relation, and especially for their own household, has denied the faith and is worse than unbeliever. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. How can we call ourselves a believer? We cannot provide for our family. Hallelujah. Amen. Not that you don't have, because of one's forgiveness. Hallelujah. You're still keeping the things they did to you when you were a child. You still hold on it. Ah, it didn't help me. The way I entered this Europe, it did not help me. I struggled by myself before I enter. There is my money. We never see my money. I will never send any one error. I will never send him. Hallelujah. But if you have the opportunity, forgive and forget. Hallelujah. Don't remain in the past. You are not a new person. All things have passed away. you are no longer suffering anymore. You are living a better life. So why not remember them, appreciate them, care for them? Hallelujah. It's not the will of God to disrespect our parents. Hallelujah. Amen. God bless you. Thank you all for watching. It is not the will of God. When you have the opportunity to have parents, don't value it. Let them be there for you. You are seeing them. They see you. They are happy. You also is happy. You are also happy. Hallelujah. Just because of one thing or the other, you just try to abandon them. It's like they are dead in your life. That is not a good thing. Hallelujah. Those of us that still have the opportunity, minus myself, I don't have parents anymore. Hallelujah. I wish I had the opportunity my parents see alive today. They will enjoy me. What is the need? God bless you that your parents are still suffering. What kind of blessing is that? The blessing needs to flow. Need to flow. Hallelujah. Let there be sign of that blessing in the life of your parents. Hallelujah. The sign cannot come up when you don't have the spirit of forgiveness, when you don't rely in the past. How they didn't help you to enter Europe. You enter by yourself. They didn't give you any pocket money. They didn't help you to follow to go to a sponsor or people that help to travel. It's only your mother or it's only your father who care for you. Then you will not choose one of the two who you will not help. You choose one of the two. That is a sin. It's not good. God bless you, brother Eddie. God bless you. God bless you, Naomi. You're welcome. That is a sin. You choose from both of them. You will not choose. You say your mom was just following you, always calling you, always trying all means for you to be able to succeed. Because your father did not care, then you forget. No, don't pay evil with evil. Hallelujah. If you are a child of God, you don't need to decide like that. They both gave birth to you. Hallelujah. Even if your mother abandoned you, it's only your father that stand for you and you became who you are today. Don't pay evil with evil. Care for both of them. Hallelujah. Their conscience will tell them what they did was wrong. They will be the one to apologize to you when they see the way you embrace them. You appreciate them. You care for them. Their conscience rejoices them. And they will ask for your forgiveness also. Hallelujah. Reconcile with them. Hallelujah. Reconcile with your parents. How can you be living a life having grudges with your parents? Hallelujah. What gain are you going to gain from it? How can you think you'll be able to have a good relationship with others when you can be able to keep malice with your parents? It's impossible. We can only deceive ourselves, not God. And we still call ourselves a child of God. We go to church. We are keeping malice with our parents. That is very wrong. Hallelujah. Anywhere you are watching me from, brothers and sisters, it's a word of encouragement. Hallelujah. Let's think about it. God bless you all. Let's think about it. Because this is the time you have for them now. This is the time they have with you. Hallelujah. Forgive them. Don't keep malice with them. Hallelujah. Because of what they did, don't keep malice with them. Don't choose one of the two, whether your mother you choose. No. Both of them are the same. Equal right. Hallelujah. No partiality. Equal right. Give them the equal right. Hallelujah. But whether it's one that cares for you, don't do that. That's unbeliever that will act in such way. Because they have not known Christ. They can rely on, this is my mother, you want to care for me. Yes, I will do anything. No. As a child of God, don't need to do that. We might be doing such thing because we don't know. But today, let us realize, only that thing you are doing can lead anyone that is living in such life to hellfire. Just only that. You may leave the rest right, but only that, separating, dividing, my mother care for me or my father was the one caring for me. No. No. Hallelujah. That is not right. Let them enjoy your money. Hallelujah. When God has blessed you, let the enjoyment flow to your parents. Let it flow to your parents, so that the blessing will come to you. It's the word of God that commanded it. Hallelujah. He says you should care for them. Care for them. Care for your family. Hallelujah. Don't be a dazoena dazowa. No. Dazoena dazowa. Rubbish. That is not good. Hallelujah. Adazoena dazowa is very, very bad. Hallelujah. Charity begins at home. Hallelujah. Thank you for watching. God bless you, Brother John Black. You are welcome. Hallelujah. Many don't have the opportunity today to have parents. They are saying, I wish I have parents. I wish I have parents. This car, I can just buy it for my parents so that I will give them house girl. I will do this house. I will build this house that I will put them there. They will no longer suffer because the suffering was too much for them. They have suffered a lot. But when God has blessed us, what do? We see abandon them in that suffering. No changes in their life. What are we going to gain when they leave tomorrow? Hallelujah. What will they take back? There are many of us today. We don't change things in their life. Change things in their life. Change something in their life. Let there be changes in their life. Let people notice there's changes in their life. They are your parents. Don't care about what they did to you in the past. When God has blessed you, don't need to rely on the past things in your life. They are not outsiders to you. Even outsiders. When God has really blessed you, you don't rely on the past. You forget the past. You bless people. You are happy. You bless people, talking of your parents. Hallelujah. We live in fine here. Many parents are suffering there in Nigeria. Hallelujah. Let us care for them. Let us ask about them. How they feel. Call them. Those that are closer to them, visit them. You're not buying ticket to go and visit somebody in Lagos or anywhere, Bubahi, wherever those places in those states. You can only take a cab, not ticket again, not ticket. Like people will buy ticket from Europe, fly down to Nigeria because to visit their parents. They sacrifice a lot. They take holiday, absent from work, and fly down to Nigeria to visit their parents. We, some people that are in Nigeria, they can't even visit. They can't visit, they can't call, they don't care. Because they don't respect, they don't regard them, they don't value them. But when they are gone tomorrow, they will be the one to cry all their tears. Dry and cry. But at the time you need to value them, what do you do? Throw it away. Let us make a U-turn. Make a U-turn. Hallelujah. You still have the opportunity to do your own part. And the blessing, they will bless you, will follow you ever, forever and ever. Hallelujah. It's very good for our parents to bless us. Hallelujah. Not to lay curse. Hallelujah. When you treat them in a bad way, there's a day they will also think and share tears. Say, this is my son, this is my daughter. Not that God has not blessed him or how, just leave me this way. He's not happy. Let them to be happy. And God will never forget you. God will surely bless you because you have obeyed his word. Hallelujah. Your life will never remain the same. First thing, we have to forgive and forget. Hallelujah. And love them. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Seek their advice and wisdom if they are godly advice. If they are godly advice, take their advice. Hallelujah. Some don't take their parents' advice. But when they fall into a problem, they will start blaming people, start complaining. But you neglect them, you never take their advice. If their advice is godly advice, take their advice. Hallelujah. Take their advice. Some look at the background because their parent is poor. They don't take any advice. What are they going to say? They don't take anything out of it. They don't take. They prefer to take someone else's advice. Hallelujah. Wisdom is from God. Hallelujah. It's not depends on the position or the way you are blessed. That wisdom is from God. God can bless them with wisdom. Hallelujah. To give you a good advice. Hallelujah. So listen to godly advice. Amen. And the other verse say in the book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 8 to 9. In the book of Proverbs chapter 1 verse 8 to 9 say, my son, hear the law of thy mother. Proverbs chapter 1 verse 8 to 9 says, my son, hear the instruction and forsake them not the Lord of thy mother. Indeed, they are a grateful rat. Hallelujah. That will yield to your head. Hallelujah. Say you should not forsake their instruction. The instruction that is of God. Hallelujah. Don't forsake their instruction. Their advice. Their godly advice. Don't forsake it. Some parents advise their children when they want to leave their husband. They will advise them. The Bible, the word of God did not say so, my daughter. My son. The word of God did not say so. Say patient. Forgive. They will encourage their son, encourage their daughter to stay. Hallelujah. And those their daughter will never forsake that word which their parents told them. They will yield to that good advice, that godly advice. Hallelujah. God bless you, Brother Monday. You are welcome. Hallelujah. They will yield to that godly advice. Amen. Praise the Lord. You say, understand them is very important. When you understand them, you can be able to have good relationship with them. Hallelujah. Have patience with them. Hallelujah. Thank you all for watching. God bless you. Hallelujah. We have learned about so many things today. Know the value of our parents and do good to them. Appreciate them. Bless them. Let them enjoy us. Hallelujah. Amen. Let them enjoy your blessing. Not when they are gone, you come and close the whole street. That is nothing. That is not this. It's an eye service. That is eye service. It's when they are alive now. Let them enjoy you. Let there be changes in their life. Hallelujah. Amen. Celebrate them, not celebrate when they are gone. They don't know that what you are doing anymore. They don't know anymore. Hallelujah. People celebrate their parents when they see they are now like 80 years, some now even 60 years. They will just host a party. They are doing bubble and they are dancing, eating. Everybody, they will now bring all the grandchildren. This is your grandson, or this is your granddaughter, or there. They will be happy together, eat, and they will still have the video. That is what we're supposed to do. May God bless you. Do something good for them. Hallelujah. Let their life not remain the same. Transform their life. And they will bless you. And the blessing of God will never pass you by. Because it's the word of God that commanded it. Praise the Lord. God bless you all. Thank you all for watching. Hallelujah. I'm about to round up now. May God bless his word into our heart. May we not just listen alone. May we amend our way so that our life will not remain the same. We have this opportunity now. Let us use it wise. Hallelujah. So that we will not say, I die no at the last day. God bless you all for watching. Thank you for coming online, for your comment, for the love, for the life, for sharing. May God Almighty bless and reward you all in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Who else are we appreciating if we cannot appreciate our parents? Hallelujah. If we cannot honor them, who people are we going to honor? Who people are we going to respect? Who people are we going to be grateful to? We cannot be able to be grateful to them that brought us to this world. Let us be grateful to them. Let us be patient with them. Let us understand them. Let us ask about them, how they do, how they are feeling. Hallelujah. Let us care for them. Hallelujah. And the Lord God will bless you as you do so. Your life will never remain the same. Because you never abandon them, the Lord God will never abandon you. Because you remember them, the Lord God will remember you. Because you forgive them, the Lord God will also forgive you. And your life will never remain the same. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God bless you all for watching. May God bless his word into our heart. In Jesus' name. Amen.